Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to take a step back from all the fun we've been having with me just PJing and just showing you products all over the place. Just take a step back and talk about my hair. I wanted to tell you more about my hair, my texture, and most importantly my porosity, and just how I manage my porosity. So I'm low porosity, so I wanted to come on and just share my tips on, you know, how to have moisturized low porosity hair. Like, once you get these tips, if you struggle with moisture and your low porosity, you should be well on your way. To start off, like, my hair texture is wiry, coarse, low porosity, high density. What else? Yeah, I guess that about covers it. I call myself ultra low low porosity to differentiate from just a regular low porosity, because with my hair being coarse, I have extra cuticle layers. With my hair being wiry, I have extra cuticle layers. So it's just like low porosity on steroids. That would be my hair. Basically, wiry hair is where your hair looks really similar wet to dry, because it just doesn't really absorb that much water, so it never seems to get wet. So that's really have a wet state. So my hair wet probably comes to this, and my hair dry is like this. And coarse is where your strand is really thick.
Very few people have this kind of texture, so it is pretty unique in the natural hair community.
So I do have a section of fine hair, like just my very nape.
The silky strands actually feel like silk, and they really clump together. And the wiry strands actually feel rough. Textures definitely feel and look more so than curl pattern.
And I think you can probably see in my videos how when it gets wet, it hangs a whole lot more. This is a strand of my hair just to show you what I mean. I have two curl patterns, like an S shape, an O shape. Sometimes my S O's at the end. This is one strand of my hair. Again, more like an S and a little bit of O at the end. And again, it's very coarse. This is like my really coily O areas in the back. And again, it's also very coarse. So with my hair being very resistant to absorbing moisture, if you have trouble absorbing moisture in your hair, then this is the video to watch. Because if I can get moisture in my hair, anybody can get moisture in their hair. If you're low porosity, you have a lot of cuticles, or they're really low, so that it's hard to get moisture in. Low porosity is healthy. It's actually the best, because if your cuticles are really sealed, then they have room to get a little bit bigger. You can take more damage, in other words. If you're already medium to high porosity and your cuticles are already raised, they are the ones that's going to be breaking off and getting damaged more easily. Because your cuticles are already exposed, so they already rub against each other and stuff like that. It's easier for your cuticles to get more damaged the higher porosity gets. And damaged hair has higher porosity, because damaged hair is damaged cuticles. Damaged cuticles is raised or missing cuticles. Raised or missing cuticles is higher porosity.
If you look at the top of the diagram, you see on the left the low porosity, which lies pretty flat. The cuticles are still going to be somewhat open, because I mean water still does get in, but it lies very flat, flatter than all the others. And then normal cuticles are like somewhat raised, and then high porosity, the cuticles are very raised. Naturally, high porosity would have a fairly even raised cuticle throughout, but the other way you can get high porosity is through damage, which is the way most people get it, because most people are naturally low porosity. When you have high porosity due to damage, you have missing cuticles, like you can see on the bottom right, and you also have broken cuticles, as well as cuticles that stay permanently raised. So basically, you treat damaged hair as high porosity. So if your hair is damaged, you should just go forward to treating it as high porosity.
So low porosity is good. You do not want to change that. You want to keep your hair the same low porosity as long as you can. But you want to manage it, and manage it by gently using heat to deep condition, gently using humectants to penetrate, water and humectants to penetrate, rather than using a lot of butters that sit. And just being aware, like being aware of, okay, I have a list of actually pH of like everything that I use in my DIY. Because pH management is also critical to me. You don't want to have super high pH stuff, because then you damage your hair and you end up with struggleable hair. Yeah, you don't want to just be having wild pH swings, having your cuticles being exposed, lifting and lowering all the time. Like, you know, anything you just keep opening it and closing it is going to eventually break off. So You want to try to keep the pH of what you're applying to your hair between 4 and let's say 8. The main thing in managing low porosity hair is just raising your cuticle just enough without causing any permanent damage. Knowing when to gently open the heat, knowing how to gently seal with like a lower pH aloe vera juice or cooler water, knowing how to use humectants to bind that water into your hair longer. I think those are some of the key things to know for a low porosity hair. Cleansing you would do with warmish water, deep conditioning and so on. Lukewarm water I guess is fine, but then you're going to deep conditioner and you're going to go, you know, plastic cap with a towel over it or a dryer for like 30 minutes to make sure it penetrates. And you can add humectants to your deep conditioner and then you rinse it out. You want to use a very hydrating deep conditioner. You want to use a deep conditioner. Of course, water is the first ingredient, but it should have a lot of humectants in there. Glycerin, honey, aloe vera juice, sorbitol, panthenol. Those are the kind of ingredients. Of course, any kind of fruit extracts. Those are the kind of ingredients you definitely want in your deep conditioner and you want high up in your deep conditioner. I distinguish between hydrating and moisturizing. Hydrating is where you get that water into your hair. Like that's the main thing, the water into your hair. Moisturizing, you have water in your hair or you get water into your hair, but you also get like
pH balancing ingredients like aloe vera juice to help seal the cuticle and seal the water in, as well as humectants and penetrating oils and mild proteins that penetrate the strand to again help trap that water in. So moisturizing is actually retaining that hydration. That's when your hair is moisturized. When you oil your hair without using a leave-in first, the cuticles tend to stay more raised, allowing more water to escape so you retain less moisture. So no, water is not the L in the LCO or LOC method. A pH balancing liquid is the L.
Basically, deep conditioning, you want something very hydrating. It also helps you retain moisture. If your deep conditioner isn't the best, or if you want to give it that extra oomph, you can add like honey, oils, glycerin, molasses, coconut milk, pumpkin, like whatever goodies you happen to have. What I usually do is like make a little DIY deep conditioner of just stuff around the house. That banana went down before I could eat it. It goes in the freezer for my deep conditioner. And I just have like a little DIY deep conditioner stash. So if I'm using deep conditioner that's kind of subpar, I would mix in some. If I happen to be doing a DIY challenge or feel like it, I would just use that alone, the DIY one in my hair for my deep conditioner. And my freezer does get filled with hair stuff. People in the house will complain. But, you know, it's effective because most times you buy some shea moisture something. Trying to think if I even have one. You pay maybe $10 or something for some shea moisture something. And a lot of it isn't, I mean, it helps your hair, but a lot of it isn't the stuff to hydrate low porosity hair. So water, castor seed oil, sterile alcohol, acetyl alcohol, benzalkonium chloride, shea butter, coconut oil. Those are the first 5 ingredients, give or take. And none of that was really stuff that's super penetrating. All of that was like the buttery stuff to put on top. But you didn't, I haven't called glycerin, honey, anything like that yet. So you can make your own little DIY mix with just good stuff, basically. Other than the deep conditioning, during the moisturizing process is another great time to be aware of your low porosity. So for example, for me, I used to rinse with cold water first off, and many of the products that I used seemed to leave a white glaze on my hair. It wasn't like buildup or flecks. It was like a glazed donut kind of white look where the product just didn't get in there at all. I started rinsing with lukewarm water and that really helped my product to absorb in my hair and not just sit on my hair. You don't really need to go to cold water if you're low porosity. You never really need to see cold water, which I guess is good, right? It definitely makes the shower more fun or the experience more fun if you're not freezing yourself. So you rinse with like lukewarm water. Then you apply your hydrating leave-in conditioner first. Even if you think your hair wants something heavier, like based on your texture, you want something heavier, you can do a hydrating leave-in first, then put your heavier leave-in over it, just to make sure it penetrates. I don't do LCO often, but if I'm doing cream, I do LCO. So after your leave-in, if you're gonna do a cream, then you apply your cream, then you oil your ends. So oil your whole hair, however you do it, not too much oil. You shouldn't be dripping with oil. But you know, you just put a few drops in your hand, rub your hands together and oil as much as you want. Also, I add aloe vera juice, but I add it after I add my leave-in and my cream and so on. So if you want to add aloe vera juice, and if you think you don't like aloe vera juice, what you may need to do is add your moisture first before adding the aloe vera juice, which has a pH of like 4 and tends to seal your cuticles even more. And then you, you know, put your gel if you're going to finish your wash and go if that's what you're doing, or twisted if that's what you're doing. In terms of midweek, if you're ultra low porosity, you don't really want to be doing a full LCO every other day. It's just going to start to sit on your hair and give you buildup, and it's not really going to moisturize. So what I do for my ultra low porosity hair is I have a spray bottle. I don't actually have one made right now. I can just show you. This one probably is just water. I have a spray bottle like this, but I have like water, like maybe this much water, a squeeze or two of leave-in. I just happen to have this up. My She Scented Cocoa Rose Leave-In, a squeeze or two of something like that. Although most likely I wouldn't use one I love this. I'll use something that didn't quite work that well for me in my spray bottle. Because, you know, it can still moisturize even if it doesn't work perfectly on its own for like freshly deconditioned hair. And a squeeze or two of like my oil mix. I use my penetrating oil mix, which is like olive, avocado, with a little bit of castor. And I shake it up. And like midweek, I would just, you know, spritz my hair, shake it up to kind of distribute the moisture. And that's about it. Like, that's usually all I do. But since I wash my face and my hairline, I get kind of soaked and stuff like that. I reapply some leave-in to my edges just to make sure that that's staying moisturized. And then my crown, just to keep it moisturized and stuff, I may apply some leave-in up there. Like just this one little spot right here. So any place that tends to get dry, or any place that's fragile, or any place that's exposed to sun or soap or something like that, midweek after you do your spritz, you can apply a little bit of leave-in. So the spritz actually does two things. The water helps to open your cuticles, so that's why you spritz, you don't just apply product. And the water helps to hydrate. And then the leave-in and the oil help to moisturize. So that's it. I mean, basically, you can live that life. You don't have to do anything more. But the extras are the clear treatment every... I've been doing it every 3 months, but I think like every 3 months, every 6 weeks, every couple months. The clear tends to have a higher pH. So you do balance it with apple cider vinegar and so on, but it still has a bit of a higher pH. So it might be that time to gently get some moisture in. So if you look at my video with my clay mix, my DIY clay mix, I took that opportunity to put in some coconut milk, to put in some honey, put in some aloe vera juice, and just while the cuticles are a little bit raised, just zap it with moisture. So it's the time you can do that. Of course, it's not going to work if you just do bentonite clay and water like some people do, which is crazy. Crazy. At least, at the very least, you want to bring the pH down, bentonite clay, apple cider vinegar, and water. But it's also a great time to throw in your moisturizers for a nice moisturizing treatment every few weeks, every 6 weeks, 3 months. Whatever. So that was it. Those are my key tips on managing low porosity hair, and also how I personally manage my low porosity hair. Thanks for watching. I hope this was informative. I hope this was fun. I hope this was helpful to you. If you have ultra low porosity, let me know. If you have trouble getting products to penetrate, let me know. Of course, it helps if you use water-soluble, curly girl-friendly products. But I don't use silicones. I don't use mineral oils. I don't use polyquats. So that definitely helps in terms of stop being able to penetrate my hair easily. But if you're doing all that and you still have issues, definitely let me know in the comments and we'll see what we can do. And if you have high porosity, let me know and I can do a video for you. I mean, I probably might do a video anyway for high porosity, even though my personal experience is with ultra low porosity. I do study all hair types and all hair textures, and I could also give you some tips for high porosity hair. So if you have high porosity hair, let me know and I'll do it even sooner. If I don't hear from you, well, I guess I'll do it eventually. So that was it, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.